Well, hello everybody, welcome back to Cookit. Here we are in my little kitchen, and today we are getting ready to make some delicious home fries that I know your family's going to love. I got this recipe years ago when I used to work at Swiss Pastries, and let me tell you, everybody wanted a side dish of our home fries. So if you're hungry and you love home fries, why don't we pan down and get you started? Okay, so as you see, we already started boiling our potatoes. And the way to find out whether your potatoes are ready or not, just stick a fork in them. If they go through all the way like so, you know they're ready. You're going to fry them too, so if they're a little undercooked, don't worry. They will cook more as you're frying them. Now, once your potatoes are boiled, take your potatoes, drain most of the water out. Don't drain all the water out, because the way to keep the moisture in the potato is to keep a little bit of water on the bottom. And then you're going to want to let these cool for about maybe an hour. You can see the little bit of water on the bottom. That's what you want. And okay, so while your potatoes are cooling in the fridge, we're going to want to start our bacon. Nothing like home fries with delicious bacon. So make sure your pan is nice and hot before you add your bacon. Once your pan is hot enough, cut your bacon in half. That'll make it much easier for you. And just start frying your bacon. If you find your heat's too high, turn it down a little bit. You don't want your bacon to fry too quickly. You want to get as much of the grease as you can from the bacon, because we're going to use the bacon grease. Okay, so I had my pan on high to heat up my pan, but then I turned it down to medium. And the reason why is because the slower you cook the bacon, the more lard or grease you're going to get from your bacon, and that's what you want. This has been on for about 3 to 4 minutes, and now it's time to flip my bacon. And I'm gonna give it another probably only 2 minutes on the other side. Now I'm gonna cook about 6 slices of bacon, but it's all up to you. If you like lots of bacon, you can cook more. If you don't like a lot of bacon, you can make less. Okay, we have our cup of grease with our bacon. Doesn't sound too appetizing, does it? But it's all ready, and look at that, our bacon cooked perfectly. So 4 minutes on one side on medium, and about 2 minutes on the other side, your bacon will cook perfectly, and you'll get just the amount of grease that you're going to need for these home fries. So let's put this aside. And okay, when it comes to the vegetables, it's really all up to you. I mean, if you don't want to use green onion and you just want to use red onion or a regular cooking onion, that's up to you. And a nice red pepper. You could use a yellow pepper, red pepper. If you like heat, you could use a jalapeno pepper. Remember, when it comes to cooking, it's all about what you like. So use the ingredients that you know you're going to love. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to cut up my green onions. Give them a little chopperoo. There we go. And the way I do that is just cut the end off. And usually this end will peel off no problem. See? So once you cut the end off, take the outer one. And just go around, make sure you get all of the outside leaves off. Pretty easy peasy, just like so. And give your onions a little wash. And I'm just going to dice them. Ramsay always says better to dice them on the side, so that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to give them a little side cut. There we are. Guess it gives you a bigger bite of the onion. And probably a nicer presentation too. So just cut them on a nice angle, just as you see here. And by the way, I always put a wet towel or paper towel under my cutting board to prevent it from slipping. That's a great tip. I know a lot of people cut themselves because their cutting board slipped. You don't want that. And I don't want you to cut yourself. So now we're just going to put our onions in this bowl. There we are. I already used half this pepper, so why not use the rest, right? I already cut into it. I'm just going to take the end, pull that little part off right there. There we go. Get all that white out of there so they don't have any of that bitter taste from the pepper. You don't want that. Okay, and just cut them very thin. I mean, if you like a big chunk of pepper, it's up to you. You can cut them thicker if you like. I like my peppers cut very thin. There we are. just basically dicing them any way you want, any size you want. This is how I like to do it. And while we're doing all this prepping, our potatoes are cooling down in the fridge. So, you know, it's not like you have to sit around and wait. You can get a head start on your vegetables and your bacon. One thing about cooking is you gotta have a lot of patience, I'll tell you, because sometimes if you rush your food, chances are it's not gonna turn out as good as you want it to, so be patient. All right, so our potatoes have been in the fridge for about an hour now, and we're getting ready to slice them and dice them. That's right. So I'm gonna keep the pan that I used for my potatoes, and I'm just gonna leave it on the side. I'm gonna wanna use a small paring knife to peel my potatoes, or you can leave the skin on. That's entirely up to you. Some people like the skin on. I personally don't. So all you have to do is start peeling your potatoes. So my potatoes are nice and firm, and that's what I like. So peeling the potatoes are pretty easy. Just basically take your knife, go all the way around. There you have it. And then come down. Hope you can see that. And if you see any brown spots like you'll see there, just take those off. I mean, it's not going to make a big difference, but, you know, we like a clean potato, right? So, and then just go around. Oops. You didn't see that, did you? I'm telling you, there's one thing about our kitchen is we're not perfect. We're always making messes in our kitchen. Probably best to do it right over the bowl, right? That's how I do my potatoes. I don't know about you. Put your paring knife on the side. Grab your handy dandy butcher knife. Got your cutting board, got your rag underneath so it's not gonna slip. Let's move this a little bit up here for you. The way to cut your potatoes for your home fries. Oh, look at that, we left a little peeling on there. Terrible, isn't it? So, best way to cut your potato, if you don't have a flat edge already, make a little flat edge. Just like so, just take the little edge off. You can still use that, don't worry, but you want your potato flat. And then you're just gonna, it's gonna slide, so just hold your potato in place, and that's it. That's how you're gonna wanna dice your potatoes, so they're nice and small, just like that. That's the size you want. Okay, so we'll just finish cutting these up. Take the end, there you go. If you want them smaller, you can do them smaller, it's completely up to you. It really doesn't matter how you cut your potatoes, they're gonna taste the same. Like my mama used to say, it's all gonna go down the same hole. You hear my cat in the background going a little crazy? That's because he wants to go outside and he's not going outside. Down. And if you want to do them even smaller, another thing you could do is once you go across, you can go sideways like this and then top them and they'll be even smaller. But I don't want that. I like a chunky potato. And the end pieces, just the same thing. Just take them, put them all together, and there you go. Put them right back in the bowl. We're done. Okay, on to the next part. Now, for this, you're going to need a lot of spices. But again, it's up to you. You can use your own flavor if you'd like, but for me, I'm going to use my special blend, which is, you're going to need 1/2 teaspoon of garlic. Throw that in there. And the reason why I like to mix my spices first is because that way I know I'm getting an even flavor right through my home fries. 1 teaspoon of paprika, that's gonna give you a nice color. 1/2 teaspoon of onion salt, because you already have onion in there. Just a couple of dashes of salt, not too much, less than 1/4 teaspoon, maybe 1/8. And the same with the pepper. Depending on how much pepper you like, you know, it really is up to you, but I don't use too much, maybe about 1/4 teaspoon of pepper. I like to use a peppercorn medley, but that's up to you. You could use regular pepper if you'd like. And this is by choice. I like a little bit of heat. So again, I'm only gonna put about 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. Not only because I like a little bit of heat. If you want a little bit of a Mexican flavor, you can always add chili and cumin. That's entirely up to you. Now for the secret blend. Chicken broth. That's right. That's where you're gonna get your flavor. Now, I don't want it to taste like chicken broth, so I'm only going to put a half a teaspoon of chicken broth. And that is all you need. Now, you just give that a little mix. And there we have it, our special blend. All right, now I put my pan on high just to heat up my pan. And now I'm going to turn it down to about medium high. This is where your bacon grease is going to come in handy. That's what's going to flavor your home fries. So just put about 2 tablespoons of bacon grease. Let that get very hot. And test your oil to make sure it's hot. It's not quite hot enough yet, so we're going to leave that sit for a little bit. You're going to want to get a nice wooden spoon or a spoon ready. Now our pan looks like it's hot enough, so we're going to start by throwing in our red peppers and our green onions. We're just going to cook that for a couple of minutes, not that too long. Give them a little sprinkle of your special spice, just a little. So all you really need is about 30 seconds to heat up your vegetables. Now it's time to add our potatoes. That's right, yummy, yummy. It's smelling delicious in here. I don't put butter in my potatoes. The reason why is because I don't want my potatoes to be really greasy. And it's smelling really nice right now. And at this point, you can start adding your spices. We got our special spice already. Make sure it's nice and even across your potatoes. You want to get that spice on every single potato. Now, I only use half right now. And if I need more, I'll know at the end. So that's entirely up to you if you like a really spicy potato. Let them brown a little bit, so give them about 2 to 3 minutes before you start to stir them up. Now, if you want at this point, you can add a little more bacon grease. That's entirely up to you. I personally don't like a lot of bacon grease in my home fries, so I'm not going to do that. You want your potatoes to be nice and brown, so give them 2 minutes, let them brown, and then give them another mix. Some people like to do the old trick of shaking them a little bit to get a little shimmer taken. See, you can see that nice golden brown coming through. That's what you want. You want that nice brown, like that. That's what you're looking for. But what I like to do is I like to take my pan, if you're feeling confident, just bring your potatoes to the end and give it a little shimmer shake. There you go. Bring them to the end and give them a shake. There you go. And we're almost done. Okay, now once you notice your potatoes are browning the way you like them, just like that, see, I love that nice golden brown, and they're not too greasy. That's why I love these fries. They're not too greasy. They turn out to be a nice golden brown, and the flavor from the bacon and the chicken base, Tasting your food is always very important, so at this point, I just want to add just another little sprinkle. And I think that's going to be more than enough. And now that they're starting to brown, that's when the best part comes in. Your bacon! Give that a little stir up now. Well, there we have it. Delicious home fries just for you. And they are so yummy. I don't know about you.
If you like our show, don't forget to subscribe.
But I'm getting ready to sit down and have my brekkie. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining me